Kickstart 14 pulls. We've got Eagle again versus Bolton again. Alright, this MU. I'm not too sure how to comment on this. This could either be really fast. Really slow. I mean, agonizing slow. Right. So he attempted the side B to rest. Didn't quite get it. And that's for a punishment. Pretty much Jamlin can do out low. Maybe a bomb there? Wow, Nair center stage, getting out 143. Young Link does have a good Nair. I can actually see a lot of Nair supports. Oh. Okay. God. Oh, jeez. It's like he's listening to me. He's smiling. Okay. Back to the match. Still got stock lead, and that's it. Boomerang up there. Down smash, good tech. Made sure that Bolton didn't pick up momentum. Up there again to take the stop. That is two stop lead for Bolton here. Oh, that was so good. That patience for the up tilt was actually amazing. He didn't aggressively up air instead. He went up to the top. Who knows? Down throw to Nair. And another Nair. Okay. So 118% on this Jigglypuff right now. But who knows, man? I won't count anyone. Never mind. Game one going to Bolton. Lack of MU knowledge right now. He doesn't really know. He's gonna take a bit of a think. See what's going on. Right, for Eagle Scout's pick, we're going to Final Destination. Now that's interesting. Okay, that's 17. But yeah, Final Destination, interesting kind of thing. Seeing as he has a projectile wall spell. However, the upside is dealing with projectiles is much more linear on this stage. Honestly, it's like Battlefield or Yoshi's Dreamland. People like Link, Young Link can use the projectiles in an angle of motion to cover a soul, a whole zone that you cannot get past without utilizing a platform. For FD though, since there are no platforms, they can only cover the floor and an upward angle, in which case the floor is not safe. There is no height advantage for that boomerang. So perhaps that's why people should be able to do much better on this stage. Good forward smash, he could take this. Oh, he didn't manage to get the hit confirmed. Oh, with grab as well. He tries to get a down throw near to Dare, but the Dare not quite making it. Oh, another thrown out there. We can. Okay. We're seeing a lot of Dares for him. Oh, that was a really bad bomb pull. Fortunately, before Fulton, the punish wasn't too big for him. Oh! Oh no, 80%, that's gonna kill out the floor of FD. That there is really strong. Oh! Up smash. Forward smash, still living though. Pretty much good DI. Okay, it's a bit too much. This is Jigglypuff. Jigglypuff has the best old Mario mobility in the game. So it's not always going to be useful, even especially at lower percentages, to try and dare in the future against them. That's a simple ledge hog. Ego stock up. His way through some projectiles. I think he's trying to destroy or near through these projectiles. Ah, rested, but that's not going to do anything really. Just the damage. Oh! I'm going to ignore that happened. They're still going ahead with it. Oh my goodness, that forward smash was so close. Oh my goodness, Bolton is clinging to dear life right now. There's the upper. Right, we're on to last stock situation of game 2 here with 65% on Bolton. One strong hit back air could do it. Or forward smash perhaps. For Bolton, he's going to have to increase that percent about 60% even more so. A dare kill percent, but now Molten in. Oh, the boomerang there to save! Clutch boomerang coming through for his boy. Oh, jeez, it's looking scary. Oh, that was a bad jump from ledge, and that's done it. Right, so it's 1-1 heading into the first game 3 so far of this pool on this setup. They have now turned off pausing. Love it. Right. Game 3, the final game of this pool set between Ego and Molten. We're on Yoshi's Island for Molten's counter pick. Now, like I said before, he's got that space where he can put projectiles into to make approaching a lot much harder for Jigglypuff. And now, a short stage as well, gonna make killing Jigglypuff easier, but the same goes for Jigglypuff in killing Youngling. So it goes both ways. But I guess in the way that Jigglypuff's gonna kill, it's gonna be a similar fashion to gimping off stage, rest, or forward smash of some sort. That down there would have killed anyway, whether it was Yoshi's or not. But yeah, as I was saying, Jigglypuff kills in a similar fashion. So on Yoshi's, what she's gonna do to you on this stage, she'd do to you on any other stage, and you die at that percent anyway. So I guess it doesn't benefit Jigglypuff so much as it will to Youngling. Because down air would kill on FD, on the ground at 80. So I reckon probably 60% in this stage or something. 80%. Like maybe 80%. Oh, double nair, interesting. Nice. Surprised Ego didn't manage to punish the boomerang. I think he was in shield stun and his buffet attack didn't cover. Or maybe he wanted to jump out of shield or wave dash out of shield and didn't come out to shield stun. Presses up Youngling with the nair, but didn't manage to convert. Okay, this stock, and there is bomb to nair. It was enough. Get bomb to nair. Getting a lot of projectile hits on Ego right now. Ego showing too much valiance in avoiding these. Forward smash not killing. I actually thought it would. Oh. Okay. They are literally trading blows right now. Good there. Gonna wake up. Get up. Oh. Okay. Still living. Ego did a bit of a flub. Still living. There's the up air. Oh wow, there was a messy bomb to weak there. Oh, good back air. Literally Ego timed that perfectly, and I don't know what's going on. Yo! Oh shit. Oh god. That was really cool. But that was not for Ego's fit up. Wow, good tech on the spot. Oh, why is he resting? He's got to be careful. He's taking damage that he cannot hold on to. Because already now, Jigglypuff is looking like she's at death percent and has two whole stocks to get through. And this is a projectile character. It's not exactly easy for her to do so. And there's the dare, and that's it. Molten takes it 2-1 over Ego.